group of kayakers up here. Right, I'm gonna go to the left. First, I'm gonna try casting over to this spot. Come on, luck or hunt frog, do your thing. It's like last time. You bass, that's all I ask. This is more of a late afternoon, early evening pond. A fisherman that was coming in with his canoe was saying how he does better at night here, so, and usually that's the case. Bass fishing, early morning, late afternoon, right before it gets dark. But I'm gonna try the old night crawler, slow things down a bit. There's a hit right here. Perch. All right, first fish of the day. Small little perch. So I stopped on this little island over here. And there's this huge pine tree. It must be about 7-8 feet around. Yeah, I'd say 150 to 200 years old anyways. You can see the bark on it. It's all big chunks. Sign of an old tree. That branch right here that's hanging over. Splitting right there. Lightning may have hit it. Mighty pine. Been through many seasons. Still here. Longer than any of us have been. Anyways. So I've decided, I bought some of these Ozark Trail frogs, topwater frogs, and I want to give them a try. This one has green on the top, yellow on the side. This one is mainly green, like a buck 97. So I'm going to give these a shot, curious to see how they work. I have another Lunker Hunt popping frog in here, as well as that's a topwater popping frog, and then I have the pocket frog here. But I'm gonna give one of these a shot. Ozark Trail, $2. They seem to be made pretty well. Pretty solid. We'll see how durable they are. I'm gonna use a Palomar knot. put it through the eyelet, come out, wrap it around, go back through the loop here, around your lure, back through, wet where the knot is, pull each end, and there you have it. Let's see how these work. Good casting distance. $2. So far, I'm fairly impressed. And you just gotta catch a few fish on it. I'm gonna move up. The action on these Ozark topwater frogs isn't as good as the Lunker Hunt frog, but it's probably good enough. Man, bass sees that from down below. Kind of hit it. Although I like how the legs on the Lunker Hunt, but this should do the job. We shall see. I hope. It's gotta be a bass hanging around here somewhere. There it is. Well, all right. What do we got here? Big sunfish. Alright. Okay, looks like it looks like a cross between a sunfish and a perch. Look at the markings on that. Doesn't it? That is something. Never seen that. It's like an interbred bluegill and perch. Definitely a pumpkin seed. Pretty good size one too. Beautiful oranges on its stomach. Gorgeous day. Just need a couple bass to make it a great day. It's like a loon over there. Go over and investigate. Yes, it is a loon. Nice. Looks like it has a fish too. Just gulped down a fish. Nice. Oh yeah, he just downed that fish. Sweet. Cool. Cool man. This guy's got a decent bass on. Just gonna head over there too. Nice. Huh? I think it's 3 pounds anyways. Perch, maybe? Yeah, perch. About the same size as the last one. So I'll just stick it on there. Probably another perch. Yep. Perch are hitting. Actually good size to eat. Perch are coming out. Bass should be coming out. Got a hit on this bobber and worm. Yep. Bluegill. Decent sized bluegill though. Wow, it's big. That is a beautiful bluegill. Beautiful colors on it. Just had a hit on the spinnerbait. Oh shit. A few more casts. And then it'll be time to go in. Come on. Even one bass here. Come on. Gorgeous out here. Hate to go in, but time to go. Ooh, the ever beautiful but eerie call of the loon. The mysterious loon. Well, that's going to wrap it up for now. Thanks for watching. If you haven't liked or subscribed, please do. I think it just had a hit. It's just a gorgeous day here in August. Very mild wind, easy to control the canoe. And this will be the last trip of the canoe for August of 2022 for me, but there'll be many more to come. I got that 3-pound bass in here last week on the same spinnerbait too. This red Strike King double-bladed spinnerbait. Oh, I got one right here. All right. Wow, he hit right by the boat. Ooh, he's a good one. It's a good one. Wow, right by that log too. This is a good fish. Oh yeah, that's a beauty. That is a beauty. Bring me right in the shore. That's another 3-pounder, I would think. At least. I would say 3, 3.5. Yeah, he hit right by that fallen stump, fallen log over there. I was just saying how this spinnerbait caught me one last week, about 3 pounds. About the same size. All right. All right, I'm gonna get him back in the water here and have him on his way. I get them on that red Strike King spinnerbait, right by that fallen log right there. So let's go catch some more. Well, it's just a perfect day here in August. We're nearing the end of August. And it's just a light breeze. So last time I was here, it was very tough to maneuver the canoe. Today it's a cinch. And it's not too hot, it's not too humid, and got that one bass. I'm hoping to get a few more before the end of the day. I like my chances between these islands. Got a little bump. There are bass lurking around here. I just saw one move. I'm gonna give this Lunker Hunt topwater popping frog a try. These lily pads look like a prime spot for bass, so. And those of you who watched my channel before, seen me use this. And I've caught quite a few bass on it. Nothing giant, but pretty much weedless. You can just skim it right over the top of these pads, no problem. The goal is to make it look as erratic as possible, like it's an injured frog. Get out on this island, stretch my legs for a minute or two. Whew, feels good to stretch the old legs, I'll tell you that. I'm gonna row over fishing this cove, move up, fish that cove over by that island. I get that 3-pounder over there last week, and I got a 4.5-pounder out of there like 7 years ago, all on spinnerbaits here and a couple ice fishing. Just picked one up here on a spinnerbait. Pickerel, got off. Jumped up, spit the hook. All right, a little action in this cove. Got a hit here, small hit, maybe he'll come back. It's
So it's really quiet out here. I've got this whole area to myself. There's only a couple fishermen over there now. And it's about an hour before dark. And very still and quiet. This is the time, hour and a half before dark. It's your best chance of catching fish. I heard one jump over here. I'm out here having a good time, enjoying the peace and quiet of nature. Listen. Okay, there's a car. Not that quiet, but. Bass just rose up right here in the front. Oh yeah, it's a decent bass. Another one on a spinnerbait, probably around 2 pounds. Sweet. That's going to wrap it up for today. Thanks for watching. If you haven't liked or subscribed already, please do. I'd really appreciate it. And until next time, enjoy the outdoors. I'll see you on the next adventure, and good luck.